Welcome to Qt Widgets and More, and the third video on file templates in Qt Creator. In the first video, we added a basic file template. In the previous one, we created a new file or a template for a new file. And in this video, we will ask the user for additional input. Remember what the user interface looked like? It had this dashlet path that we would like the user to ask, or like to ask the user, and then use that in the generated code. So let's see what that looks like. Let's start looking at what we have already. Control N, choosing KW dashlet, and here is the definition of the class. We didn't touch that at all until now. But what I really just want is the class name. I don't need a base class because I already have a base class. All this stuff with include, all of those go away. Header file and source file already given from the class name. The path I still need, and I need my new dashlet path. So let's go and see what our wizard.json look like. Wizard.json, this section up here, we've seen that numerous times. That's the general section. Then we've got the option we saw that in the previous video. That is a bunch of variables that I can use throughout. Finally, down here is my pages. This is what we, and let me just go back again, in my control N, kwr dashlet here, see kwr dashlet define class and all these things. So that's the part that I want to change. Define class, good enough. Shorthand details, I love that. Type ID fields, whatever that means, I don't know. Here is class. I definitely want the class still. Actually, let's get the dashlet path in here right away. So name, class, I'll bet you that is a keyword just like the other dashlet path. And here, dashlet path, that's the user visible string. Is it mandatory? Yes, it is. What type is it? It's a line edit, cool. Data, ooh, that is a regular expression. I love those. So they go like this, A to C, A to Z, depending on whether you're American or European. Well, the Americans call it C, why is that? A to Z, I'm European. So we can even have it like a number of these here. And I want it to end in not a dash or not in a slash, and not in a space. So that's my validator. Let's see what we else have down here. The base checkbox, not gonna have that. Baseline edit, not gonna have that. A space, okay, I didn't know I could do that. Include bunch of different things here. Include main window, include declarative, include Qt quick. Include. Add object macro, I'm not gonna do that either. Spacer two, header file name, we're getting there. I didn't want that either. And finally, my path. I definitely want my path in there. Let's try and save this. Go back to Qt Creator. Magic key, that's what's Windows key of 12. New, it said a bunch of things here. That's cool. Don't panic yet. KW dashlet. Hallelujah. You can translate that into your own religion, whatever that is. Class name, dashlet path, and ABC, that could be a good dashlet. Ooh, it cannot end in slash, so therefore it's highlighted in red. It could go like this. That was the UI part of the dashlet path. But I also need to actually use it in my template. And remember, it was in the header file that I wanted this dashlet path as a list of strings. So let's see if we can get it in there. I'm in file.h, that's a template file that I use for when I generate new files. Return folder, my dashlet title. I would like that to be replaced with percent dashlet path. That was the key that I gave to it in there, like this. and a percent, open brace, a key, close brace. That's how I expand keys from my user interface into these files. Let's save it. I'm good at remembering saving nowadays. And reload, Control N, Qt Viewer. I'll give it a name, AQ. What a great name for a class. And it's in ABCDEF. Next, finish. And whatever. And this starts looking peculiarly wrong. Well, at least let's go to the header file generated. You can see that it does say ABC/GEF down there now. It's not like a string list. But what's even more concerning is that it's called percent header file name. If you have watched enough of these episodes by now, you will know that I made this mistake purely so you could learn from it. Actually, the percent header file name was one of those variables. Well, header file name was one of those variables that came out of those two line edits that I just deleted in the user interface. So let's go back there and fix that up. I already went ahead of you and searched for header file name. And of course, that is the file name that my header file should be generated to. But hey, we actually did some things right similar underneath for the UI file name. So maybe we can just use that. So it was called header file name. Yes. And it's a class.h. And I'll bet you that we also want .cpp here for our cpp file name. And is that exactly how it was spelled? Let's see. No, it was not. It was called source file name. There we are. Source file name. And maybe I should take that key here just to be safe above where I'm referencing it the first time. Save. Yes, Jesper, good. And go back here, magic key for reloading or asking to reload, Control N. I want my dashlet, should we call it? I'm running out of stuff to call it. I can call it ABC and it'll ask me if I really want to overwrite. It's in ABCDEF again. Next, yes, and yes. Now it actually got back to abc.cpp. And abc.h. Notice it doesn't say abc. What I really would like it to say down here is like this. But to do that, I need all the energy I can get from you. So give me some energy. Thanks. Well, I have a 6 and a 9-year-old at home here. So I watch way too much cartoons. Those of you watching cartoons would get that reference. The rest of you just observe what I'm doing next. I'm back in the template file. What I want is to have my path escaped into a list of strings. So that is truly difficult to get working. So I found the easiest way is just to take it out of here so I'm not getting confused with all my braces. So what I want down here is I want this to be going into something like quote ABCDEF. Well, like this. That's the end result. So let's see. If I now write percent open brace JS colon, then the following thing up until this closing brace here is a JavaScript expression that QCreator will execute for me. If I change this into a string like this, then I can execute string operations on it. And one of the JavaScript string operations is .split on a string, close like this. And then I wanna join it, and I wanna join it with a quote, comma, quote. Yeah, that is gonna work easy. It took me a few times to make it into 3 escapes there and 3 escapes there. Now I got my quote properly executed. Finally, I want, this gives me ABC and then this quote, comma, this quote. and then def. So I want these ending and beginning quotes around it. Goes like this. And now take this whole shebang, put it up here, and we'll clean up this stuff down there. Fingers crossed. Go over to my Qt Creator. There it is. And magic key again for reloading. Control N for new. This dashlet here. And the class is ABC. And it is HI new employee. That could be a new dashlet there. Next. Finish. Yes, I want all of these overwritten. And are you ready for it? I can't wait. Here we are. Error in HR new employee dot split slash syntax error expected token. Yes, that is the pain that it is. And we'll just have a small break. And welcome back to the break. I hope that you observed me down in the corner here rather than the code, because let me show you. I can nuke it all. I can do like this. And now, kw-dashlets. ABC, HI hire a new blah, blah. And yes, yes, yes. And F4. And now here we are, return HI. HR hire a new. And what was the problem? Oh, well, you know, JavaScript, I forgot this quote here and this quote down there. Enjoy the beauty of this JavaScript. Not fun at all, but doable. It takes a bit of messing around. But see, now I actually managed to get my user interface into a state where new dashlet will also have this filled in. And that was one of the things that I often forgot whenever I created my new dashlets in my project. Whew. Can you observe the sweat on my forehead? This is like real work, kind of. But as you saw, just a bit of fiddling and it is doable. There's one more video in the series, and that is, how do I move it into the Qt section? It was in the C++ section now. It's not entirely straightforward, so let me do that in a separate video. I'll put that out tomorrow or the day after. Until then, have a great time. I'm Jesper Pedersen. I'm from QTopia. You've been watching, well, you know, Qt Widgets and more.